Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Mike with HiFiInsider.com. Today, I have a brand new product to share with you. This is the and sort of an entry-level piece from Fostex, Japan. It is a planar magnetic headphone. It is the Fostex T60RP, which is the next, I think, the next model from the very popular, the T50RP. The T50 is really popular among the modification folks. Mr. Speakers, Dan over there, Mr. Speakers, started out the company modifying the Fostex T50RP. Very well-respected product line. So as you can see here, it's a pretty simple box, not much frills. I'm gonna unbox it real quick. Get a Fostex sticker, really nice. Safety information, owner's manual. Tells you a little bit about what are the options that are available, it looks like. And here are the specifications. 50 ohms is actually quite good. 92 dB sensitivity is actually not super efficient. It can take up to 3 watts of power. So that's a lot. That's typical of planar magnetics that I found, that they can handle a lot of power. Here are the optional cables that you can get with this headphone, just in different languages. And then the warranty card, I guess. So you get a straight cable, 3.5, with the quarter inch adapter. So this side goes to the amplifier side, or your mobile device. And then this side goes to the headphone. And then you have a pretty nice pouch, branded Fostex. Here's the star of the show. Beautiful wood. This is real wood. This is African mahogany. Very nice. This is actually looks better in person to me than in the photos. The photos really doesn't do it justice. The wood just feels really premium. It's all metal construction here. Now this part here, I'm not a fan of. This stuff, to me, it kind of gets caught on things. Like if you run your finger through your hair when you're wearing the headphones, your finger gets caught on this. This side goes to the cable. So it's one-sided cable. Very nicely made. Nice leather headband. The ear pads are real leather. So they're not synthetic, so should be very comfortable. Nice opening. And you got Fostex on top. So I'm going to spend some quality air times with these and then give you guys my impressions of them. All right, I'm back. So I spent about 3 weeks with these headphones. I use them daily with my Lehman Audio headphone amplifier. It's basically my standard setup now. I really like the sound of these, and I think that they are really comfortable. For the price, they sound the part. A few things that I did notice, though, being able to tell which side is which is a little bit difficult. The markings are quite small, in my opinion. But you could quickly tell by the cable side. It's always on the left side. Another thing about this headphone, it squeaks. Not when you're wearing it, but when you're handling it. See that? The yoke here squeaks quite a bit. It doesn't do that when you're wearing it, but it's just when you're handling it, just squeaks quite a bit. And I feel that I expect a little bit better from Fostex. The good side is that I love cable options that you have. You can get it in a wide variety of different cables. Now, those are all optional. You can get it in 2.5 millimeter balanced, 4.4 millimeter balanced, or 4-pin XLR balanced. So I really like that. These are all options available directly from Fostex. And makes it very flexible. Now, I don't have those cables here to test, but I suspect that it should improve on the imaging and the sound stage as well. Maybe a little bit more clarity in the imaging. Now, the headphones, they sound good. They're not offensive at all. The mids are very smooth, but the highs, for me, it's got a bit of a peakiness to it where it brings out the sibilance in some of the music, or if you're listening to podcasts. It's not really offensive, but it's there. So if you're sensitive to it, I suggest that you listen to this headphone first before you make a purchase. Now, the bass are very good, the bass are very full. The mids, really smooth. I think that the mids are very natural sounding. Typical of planar magnetic headphones. Overall, I don't think that there's anything offensive about this headphone in terms of the way it sounds. It's priced correctly. It's got a lot of options. The build quality is very good. Aside from the squeakiness, the wood, it feels very premium. It's a good headphone. It's a good headphone for $300. So the big question is, do I recommend this headphone? I think this is a good starting headphone for a lot of people who wants to dip their toes into planar magnetic. And if you are inclined to do some modifications, this headphone is very easy to do that and to make it maybe even better. I don't do any modifications myself, but there are a lot of DIY guys out there on the web that are very handy at making changes in the sound department. And this headphone, I think, it hits a lot of positive marks in terms of the build quality, the materials that they used, and the construction. You can basically replace most of the parts. So thanks for watching my videos. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you guys again in my next video. Bye bye.